Hi guys, it's Nicole and Albert here again from Relax My Dog. We're here every week answering all of your doggy related questions. This week we're on the fifth episode of our baking series, and today we're going to be making some sardine and oat cakes for your dog. Now these are some really tasty treats and they only include four ingredients, just like every other recipe that we've given you so far.
Okay, so for this recipe we've just got four ingredients. We've got 1/3 cup of porridge oats. We've got 1 cup of whole wheat flour. We've got 2 tins of sardines in oil, which I've just mashed up with a fork. And we've got 1 garlic clove. Okay, so the first thing that we're gonna do is we're just gonna add the garlic clove to the sardines and just mash that in. Now, I've just used a tiny one for Albert because, as you may have heard, a lot of people believe that garlic is toxic for dogs. Everything in nature can be toxic in certain amounts. So common salt can be toxic and it can kill dogs, and even water. So yeah, garlic may be dangerous when fed improperly, but it shouldn't keep you from using it in small amounts because it actually can be really good for them as well. For example, in flea and tick season, if you just add a little bit of garlic to your dog's food for 2 weeks before it, it increases the natural oil in your dog's coat, so it repels the fleas. It's also shown promise with a number of different cancers in dogs as well. The compounds in garlic increase the immunity and enhance the natural killer cells, and these destroy pathogenic bacteria and cancer cells. So there's a lot of positives to garlic in your dog's food. So what I'm going to do is just pop in the description how much garlic you should feed your dog based on its weight. So for Albert, it's a tiny amount, but it does increase his immunity, so I will use it in dog treats sometimes. Okay, so then once you've mashed up your sardines properly, just add your oats and your flour. And then we're just going to mix this until it's all in a nice dough-like ball. You will probably have to add some water to this just to make it stick a little bit better. Okay, so once you've done this, I just want you to flour out your surface ready to roll. So the dough that you have should look something like this. So I just want you to make it into a dough ball and make sure that it's all sticking together fine. So if you have added a little bit of water to it, then that should work perfectly. And then, as usual, I haven't got a rolling pin, so I'm just going to knead mine out, but if you have got a rolling pin, then it's a lot easier. If you need to add a little bit more water along the way, see how mine's sort of breaking up because of the oats, then that's fine too. Okay, so once your mixture is all rolled out onto your floured surface, just use a cookie cutter or a shot glass, as I'm doing, to cut out your cookies. And once you've cut them out, just pop them onto a baking tray like this. You can lightly grease it, but this has got the oil from the fish in it, so you generally won't have to grease them too much. Okay, so I've preheated my oven at 190 degrees, and I'm just going to pop these in the top of the oven for 25 minutes. Okay, so once they've been in there for 25 minutes, just take them out of the oven and leave them to cool down for an hour. Should be lovely crispy and brown like that. Okay, so once your treats have all cooled down, we're just going to, instead of like usual videos where I just pop them in an airtight container, I'm actually going to put them in the freezer because they've got sardines in them. So just to keep them fresh and all right for your dog, I'm just going to pop them in a freezer bag like this.
Sit down. Good boy. Good boy. Good boy.
We really hope that you've enjoyed the fifth episode in our baking series. If you did, please do give us a big thumbs up and send us any pictures of your doggies enjoying the treats. You can tag us in them on Facebook or Instagram, or you can send them over to relaxmydogmusic@gmail.com. We've got a poll on this week, just like last week. We'd like to know which of the treats your dog has preferred so far. If you have any ideas for next week's video, please leave them in the comments section below. And that's it for us for now, so we'll see you again next week. Bye!
Hi guys, it's Nicole and Albert here from Relax My Dog. We're here every week answering all of your doggy related questions. This week is the fourth episode in our baking series, and today we're going to be making a treat that only requires three different ingredients, which is obviously a very easy one for all of you to make. Okay, so for today's recipe, we only need three different ingredients. We've got 1/4 cup of coconut oil, we've got 2 cups of quinoa flour, and we've got 1 sweet potato, which I've just put in the microwave for 6